Hello everyone, I am Mr. Sachin Rathod, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand Shop Technology College. Today we are seeing the further parts of the break. The learning outcome of this session is student will be able to understand the working of single block or shoe break. So in the last lecture we have seen the case 2, that is when the block drum is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, we are applying the force P in the downward direction. So we are getting the value of the P, that is Rn in bracket A minus mu B divided by the PL. So we will continue this part. So we are getting the value, that is P is equal to Rn in bracket A minus mu B divided by L. This is not divided by the L. So from this equation we will get the concept of self-energized or self-locking break. So you can think about this. What is mean by self-locking break and the self-energized break? Okay, let's see. The self-locking break is nothing but without applying any kind of the external force, the rotating drum will get stopped. So that is called as a self-locking break. And the self-energized break is nothing but, so some amount of the frictional force will minimize the effort, that is the force, that is called as a self-energized break. So we will see the both concept. So here in that equation, that is a P equation, that is a force applied, we are observing that here is A minus mu B. If A is less than or equal to mu B, then we are getting the value of the P is 0 or negative. It means that without applying any kind of the force on the lever, the drum will get stopped. So such condition is called as a self-locking break. So this is a condition for the self-locking break. That is A should be less than or equal to the mu B. So the next one, that is P is equal to A, if you multiply this, A into the Rn minus mu Rn into the B divided by the L. So here the this concept, this bit A into the Rn is nothing but moment of normal reaction about the fulcrum, and mu Rn into the B is moment of frictional force. That is a F is equal to mu Rn, moment of frictional force about fulcrum. So in that equation we are observing that this moment of frictional force, that is a mu Rn about the fulcrum, shows the negative value, means it minimizes the effort applied at the end of the lever, that it minimizes the P. So this condition will reduces the effort at the end of the lever. So such condition is called as self-energized break, means it reduces the effort. So in our actual case, the break should be the self-energized and it should not be the self locking break. So we have seen the two bit, first one self locking break and second self energized break. Okay. So now we will see the third case, that is when the line of the action of the braking force passes through the distance B above the fulcrum point O of the lever and the brake wheel rotates in the clockwise direction. So this condition, this is a drum block, this is a lever and that is a O point below this B distance, length of the lever, P force is applied, this is the distance A and B distance above the, this is a B distance. As the drum rotates in the clockwise direction, the frictional force F is equal to mu RL is acting like this and this is a normal reaction RN. Now we have to calculate the braking torque. So same here is there, as TB is equal to F, frictional force F into the radius of the drum, F is equal to mu RN into the radius of the drum. And for calculating the value of the RN, you have to take the moments about this fulcrum. So therefore P into L minus RN into A, and this is rotated in the clockwise direction, so plus mu R n into distance B is equal to 0. Therefore P L is equal to R n into A minus mu R n into P. Therefore P L is equal to R n in bracket A minus mu B. Therefore R n is equal to P L upon A minus mu B. Therefore T B is equal to mu into PL upon A minus mu B into R. So here also we are observing that A minus mu B term is there. So here also the two cases are there, that is a self-locking and self-energized brake. So as the brake is rotated in the clockwise direction, now we will see the next drum rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. This is a drum rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. This is a P force, this is a position of fulcrum O, that is a B distance below, this is a, this is a length of the lever L. So R N, as the drum rotates in the anticlockwise, so frictional force F will be acting like this. So you have to take the moments about O. Therefore we are getting P into L minus R N into this distance A and this minus F into B is equal to 0. Therefore P into L is equal to R N into A plus F into B is equal to R N into A plus F is equal to mu R N into B is equal to Rn in bracket A plus mu B is equal to P into L. Therefore Rn is equal to PL upon A plus mu B. Therefore braking torque TB is equal to mu into PL upon plus mu B into R. So by using this equation we can easily calculate the braking torque under this condition. So depending upon these conditions, the numericals are there, so we will see that numericals in the next session. These are my references. Thank you.